will call, it will return a promise object. A promise can be a success or failure. So sometimes in the interviews they will call you how you are going to work with the promises or something. On the promise, it provides what function, how you are going to register your function, then contains what success or failure. So this is the way it's going to be worked out. Now I'm asking, so what is mandatory? Success is mandatory, but failure is you can provide or you can skip that one also. So this is the way you are going to work in your application related scenarios. Now today, let's see end-to-end routing example. Before that, let me show you how to work with the server, means how to create fake REST API server to test your Angular examples locally, to test your Angular examples locally. Now I am asking, what is today's class is about? What? Creating fake JSON server. Why I am calling this one fake is, observe, in any application we have client side and server side. Client side as well as what? Server side. So if I am working with the Angular, I require client side, we are going to write the Angular JS code. At server side, what are the technologies, different technologies? Java, .NET, Node.js. Node.js. So we need to write this code at the server side, but I am not yet ready to write this code, but I want to test my Angular.js application. I am repeating once again. So right now I don't have the developer, means I don't have the capability to write the Java, .NET and Node.js related application. Still I want to test my Angular.js application with the REST APIs. So this APIs, how you are going to create this one? By using JSON server. It is actually works as a fake API which simulates the server application, which simulates a server side application. Now I am asking a simple question: are we using the real world means genuine server application or a fake application? But why we are doing this one? To learn Angular in better way, because Angular is simplifying only what environment? Client side environment only. Angular simplifies only what environment? Client side environment only. It doesn't simplify server side environment. It doesn't simplify server side environment. So my requirement is I want to work with the Angular in better way, so that I can learn the coding in proper way. So how I can do this one? By simply writing fake API server, by simply using fake API server. Now what are the steps, sir, for this one? First step, install Node.js environment. Install Node.js software into machine or into system. Sir, where exactly this software is going to be available? So guys, in this internet world, you can't ask that question. Very simple one. What is a search query we are going to configure? Google. Google Baba is there. Ask Google Baba. He will give you anything. So guys, what is the one we are going to search here? Node.js download. Node.js download. So just ask the Node.js download and automatically it will provide you the corresponding link. Now observe based on your confirmation, now go for either 64 bit or 32 bit or 32 bit based on your operating system. Sir, how can I identify my operating system? Simple, right click properties, right click on your my computer properties, and you can observe what is the operating system here. Either 64 bit operating system or 32 bit operating system, you can identify and you can use it out. So this is the way you are going to identify the machine related one. So I am asking very simple thing. What is the one? Install what software? Node.js software. Now I am going to give you the URL. Node.js.org we are going to do. Now I am going to give you the URL. What is the next step, guys? Install Node.js software. Download Node.js software into the system as well as install it. So, sir, I already downloaded. Control J. Yeah. So here I downloaded the one and it is asking to execute the things. Now you can see, click on next, very simple one, click on next, finally just install button. I already installed it, that's why I'm clicking on what, cancel. Now after completion it is asking for what, finish. It will ask for what, finish. Now once you install the software into your machine, you need to execute open command prompt and execute the following command. npm install hyphen g json hyphen server. npm install hyphen g json hyphen server. It's going to be install the fake API server related software, that package, into your machine. So once you do this one, let me configure how to do that. I am opening the command prompt. How to open the command prompt? What is the run command I need to use? I'm asking the question. How to open the command prompt, guys? It's not about the rocket science. It is a very easy question. How to open the command prompt? Windows R. Then we need to go for what? Start run command and CMD. So now I open the command prompt and observe. What is the command I am going to run it out? npm install -g json -server and just hit the enter. Automatically it installs the Node.js software into our machine. Node.js software into your machine. That means JSON-server software into your machine. So this is the way you are going to install the JSON-server into your machine. So now you can see all the, it is installed into my machine. Where exactly it is installed? In my users folder. In my users Kanmuri, and it is available for entire system. So now I am asking how you are going to install What are the required software for our application? What is the one I'm required? What is the software first I need to install? Node.js software. What is the software we are going to install? Node.js software. Sir, why Node.js, sir? Very simple thing. Right now, JSON server is created. JSON server is created by using what software? Node.js. That's why we required that environment to execute or to use JSON server. Why Node.js means it is why Node.js, sir? Because JSON server is used, means it is actually created by using what? Node.js. That's why we required Node means JSON server software. So this is the way you are going to work it out. Next step, prepare test data. Prepare test data. So how you are going to do this one? So how you are going to prepare the test data? By creating JSON file. By creating JSON file. I will give you this JSON file and use in your application. And as well as I'm going to show you the things. So right now, every JSON object is going to be start with what? Open braces and curly braces or not? How you are going to JSON object? So guys, I am asking you a question. How the JSON object will be there? Open braces and curly braces. Now in this one, we are going to have the key. What is the key I am providing here? Students. What is the key I am providing? Students. Students colon, we need to provide a group of values. So right now I want to test my application with the students data. That's why I'm creating what is the array? Students. In this one, we need to provide a couple of values. Now everything is a object. Now observe, I want a student table with ID value 1 with the record these two things, ID value and name equal to student 1. So name 2, 3, 4. In the same way, student 2, student 3, and student 4. So this is the way we are going to configure our things. Again, I am doing this one and save it as a what? Save it as a JSON. So I'm going to configure db.json. I'm going to configure it as a what? db.json on the UI, on the UI. Now I'm going to use this file as a test data or fake data to simulate student table. Now I means I am placing this one into a separate folder and I call it as a what? Server. New folder and I am going to configure as a what? JSON server. JSON server. Now you can see I created the JSON server folder, and in this folder I'm going to place my db.json file. In this folder I'm going to place my db.json file. So how to create this db.json file? So once I open this one, now tell me what is the first thing we are going to do, guys? What is the first thing we are going to do? Create what JSON file? Create what JSON file? Prepare db.json file, and everything we are going to do. Then execute json-server db.json command. Input this JSON server file with the fake data. It is not the real world data, but we are using what? Fake data. So automatically it's going to be execute this one. Now execute this one in your file, in your folder. Now observe here, what is the command we are going to use? It cmd, and this is my command. Now you can see you have the resource for students. Now simply type localhost 3000 / students. Your data is available or not? Your data is available for insertion, means of everything. The resource will be available as a fake API. Means it is giving the data in what format? JSON format, and you no need to write a single line of code. Only you need to configure the JSON file. Only we need to configure the JSON file. Now I am opening this JSON file and I am writing once again and understand this one. So right now, how you are going to write this code, guys? I am asking you to first write what? Open curly, open braces and closing the braces. And in this one, I want to represent what table? Students table. Colon like this, because students table contains every table contain one record value or multiple record values. Multiple means that's why we need to represent it as a what? Array. That's why we need to represent it as a what? Array. We need to represent it as a what? Array. By we need to represent it as a what? Array. What is the next step we are going to configure, guys? We are going to configure array of values. We are going to represent it as a what? Configure it as a what? Array of values. Here 3000 is the default port number. Localhost 3000 means our server is running on default port number. Now tell me, each and every record I am fixing it to what? ID value, having what property? ID property, as well as what property? Name property. Think it like your student table contains, your student table contains what are the columns? ID column, as well as what column? Name column, as well as what column? Name column. As well as what column? Name column. So I'm going to configure two things, student one. So we are going to configure both of them. Now observe, what are the values I'm going to configure? Two, as well as what? Three. Now we can say two as well as what? Three. Sir, I want to test with multi-table data. So sometimes we need to test with multi-table data. At the time, how I can do that? Simply configure another key here, employees, this way. So configure the test data and put it into your array. So likewise, you can configure not only single table, but you are going to configure multiple tables like this. Now this is the way you are going to work it out. is are you following what is the file we are creating, db.json, and this is the way we are going to configure. Now I want to work with, sir, only ID and name properties or any properties we are going to have it. Sir, ID should be there as well as name should be right, employee table also. Here, what is the one I'm going to configure? RK, my name, and Deepak, and Sacha. And in the same way, I'm having what? Salary also. I can have different properties also. What is the different properties we are going to have it? Salary, colon, we are going to have what? Let me have some 1 lakh. 10,000 is very less. Now let me configure the file name. Now you can understand the things. Now observe, someone is asking, sir, db.json is fixed. No, you can change it. I can configure like project.json also. At the time, what is the command, guys? What is our file name? project.json. So you can configure different email IDs also, different JSON files also. So at that time, what is the one we are configuring? Now you can see in the URL. Now you can see in the URL contains what? Localhost colon 3000, as well as it represents what? Students table data, and we have separate API for students, separate API for what? Employees. So likewise, you can configure your own things. So right now I have the employees also. And I can work on employees. So let me show you the things. Now you can see we get the employees related things or no. So this is the way you are going to. Can we change the port number? Yes, we can do, but I will suggest you to go with the 3000 because it is easy to test in your applications. When you are working with the JSON server, you can change it by providing json-server and --port. We can use it out. --port, you can use it out. So likewise, it's going to be working out. Change the JSON port number, and based on your thing, it's going to be working out. Now, how to test your application with this one? So let me configure the employee related things in our application. So guys, are you following until so far is good? So what is the configuration we are doing? Configuring fake API server, as well as right now I am doing this thing in our machine. So right now, what are the steps we need to do, guys? Install what software? Node.js software. Install what software? Node.js software. What is, after installing the Node.js software, what you need to do? Open the command prompt, execute what command? npm install -g json-server command. Then prepare your test data, and you can configure any name you want. But usually I prefer to use what? db.json. db.json contains test data or real project data. I'm asking the question. db.json file or project.json file is having test data, real project data. I'm asking everyone, give me the answer. It contains test data. Very good. It contains what? Test data. It contains, always contains what? test data. So why I am using this one? Because I am not in a position to write my server side right now, but I completed my client side. So at that time, how you are going to test this one? By simply executing what is the command, json-server, and what is the file name we are going to configure, the file name .json file. The extension should be .json. So once we have this one, we can do the things. Now let me open the JSON server and observe, sir, where exactly I need to do this one, or how to open the command prompt, how to open the command prompt in the current folder. So usually if you open the command prompt, it will by default open in your user folder. But my requirement is, I want to open the command prompt in the JSON server folder. So in the address bar, type cmd directly. So it will automatically open the command prompt into your folder. So this is the way you are going to work it out. So no need to write, no need to do like Windows or cmd and go to certain folder by using change directory, such kind of thing. You can directly open the command prompt in the current folder by simply writing the cmd in your machine. So this is the very useful shortcut or not. So if you are opening this one, suppose I want to go to into this folder, what is the headache I need to do? Go to the cmd and cd I need to go to the practice folder, then I need to go to the JSON server folder. Like this. Usually you are going to configure like this. But how to open the command prompt directly into the current folder? Simply what is the command we are going to execute here? Cmd. Simply execute the cmd. So guys, it is very useful shortcut once you are understand the trick. So usually we open what? Windows or cmd. But my requirement is what? Very simple one. Simply type the cmd in your address bar and automatically you will get the things. So this is the way you are going to install your Node.js software. And prepare your JSON server. Now I have the employee data, sir. How to work with this employee data now? Now tell me, what is a URL now? What is a URL to configure in your HTTP? I'm asking the question, how to communicate with the employee data now? Localhost 3000 / employees. This is your URL. Now let me configure one list view with this one, as well as insert and everything, and project related organization. Very good, guys. Very good. So today's example dealing with what? Employee related things, and let me configure them. New folder. Now I am asking the question. I am doing the repeated work, guys. So I ask you to participate, everyone. Now tell me, what is the first step we need to do? Write what tag? Script tag. By writing what tag? Script tag. So script tag text equal to and include what JS file? Include what JS file? Angular.js. Angular.js. Now what is the next one we are going to configure, guys? Include our own script file. What is the one we are going to configure? App.js. 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 So guys, this is the way you are going to configure. Now tell me, in the app.js, what is the thing we need to configure? Create the module. Create the module. How to create a module, guys? We already know angular.module, module name comma dependencies. So right now I'm working with what application? Employee app. Right now I'm working with what application? Employee related functionality. In the same way I need to create a controller. And how to work with a controller? Employee controller. Which controller? Employee list controller. Module. On this module I am calling what? Controller. Controller. On this controller, what is the employee name? Employee list controller. Employee list controller comma, we are going to write the function. This function should accept what parameter? I'm asking the question. How to work with the parameters? What are the parameters I require? Everyone type the answer. Everyone type the answer. What is the configuration? Employee. So here we are going to configure scope. And observe, I want to communicate with the server. So at the time, what is the configuration we are going to do? Create our service. So right now we need to use what function here? Service function. We need to use what function? Service function. Now tell me, what is the service I need to write here? Employee service. We need to write what service? Employee service. Employee service having what dependency? Employee service having what dependency? $HTTP. Employee service having what dependency? $HTTP. Now observe how to write this one. This dot get students or get employees. What is the method name I need to configure? This dot get employees. So this is the way you are going to configure. Now observe, what is the method we are going to configure? Function in this way. So right now, what is the code I need to? How to get this one? Observe, what is the one? Return $HTTP.get. $HTTP.get. How to identify this one, guys? What is the code we need to configure? The URL, right? http://localhost:3000. What is the thing I need to configure here? Employees. We need to configure employees. So let me verify whether this URL is correct or not. Yes, it is correct. So this is the way you are going to configure in your application. Now tell me, here I need to provide the data binding or not? How to create a variable, guys? Scope dot employees equal to empty array. And what is the next one? What is the next one we are going to configure? Get the data. So right now we need to configure scope as well as what data here or not. What is the configuration we are going to do? Employee service. What is the next one we are going to configure, guys? What is the next one we are going to configure? Employee service dot, what is the method we are going to configure? Get employees. On this one I need to configure what function? Then function. On this one I need to configure what function? Then function. Then function accept what? Function one as well as what? Function two. Now observe, function one deals with what scenarios? Function one deals with what scenario? I am asking the question, repeat, just give me the response back to me. What means I am seeing very less responses from you guys. What is the one we are going to configure? Success. Very good. And what is the next one we are going to configure? F2 deals with what? Failure. F2 deals with what? Failure. So right now I am so confident and I never fail. So let me configure only success scenario. Function, you can configure any variable name or only server data. Any variable name, very good. So right now I am configuring ABC. So this ABC contains what property? This ABC contains what property? Data property. Very good. So the data I need to assign to what reference variable? Employees. Scope dot employees equal to ABC dot data. Scope dot employees equal to ABC dot data. Everything is configured properly. Now I need to configure in the UI. What is the ng-app I need to do? Employee app. What is the ng-app module name? Very good. And what is the next one we are going to configure? Div tag. Configure what tag? Div tag. Div tag contains what? What is the configuration, guys? I'm asking the question. What is the configuration? How to use the controller? What is the attribute I need to configure? Everyone type the answer. Don't sit idle in the class. ng-controller. What is the configuration we are going to do? app.js employee list controller. So likewise we are going to configure. Now I am going to configure table tier. What is the next one? Td. So right now, sir, how many table data I need to configure? Now observe, how many properties are there? Three properties are there. I want to display three properties. That's why we need to configure three table data here. So now observe, what is the configuration we are going to configure here? ng-repeat equal to emp in, what is the collection name? I need to configure here. What is the data binding? Employees. Very good, guys. Very good. You are following the class perfectly. Awesome. So we are going to configure this one. Now tell me, employee in, what is the configuration? Employees. Now observe, how to access the data here? Expression. What is the reference variable? Employee. So at the time, what is the configuration? emp.id, emp.id. So this is the way we are going to configure. emp.name, and finally emp.salary, emp.salary. So this is the way we are going to configure. Now let's see the example working or not. Open with Firefox. Now you can see the data is coming correctly or not. Guys, how to work with the different table data? Simply, you need to configure the things or not. Now, what are the configurations we are doing, guys? Very simple configuration. Now, let me repeat once again how to configure our server. How to configure our server. Now, you can see how to configure our server. Download what software? Node.js software. And execute what command? npm install -g json-server command. json-server command. So see your chat message, guys, once. So this is the one things we are going to configure. What is the next one? So first we need to install what software? Node.js software. Why we need to install the Node.js software, guys? Very simple thing. Very simple thing. Why we need to install? Because JSON server actually, created by using what software? Node.js software. Node.js software. So that's why we need to install Node.js. Next step is what? JSON server expecting what data? JSON test data. That's why we need to create our db.json. Sir, this one fixed. No, we can change the file name. And what is the command we are going to execute? JSON-server. Whatever the folder this JSON file contains, abc.json is also good, but go with the good names, guys. Amir, that is good. So that is the way you are going to work it out. Now once you do this one, what is the next step? Once we install everything, we can configure our servers, then execute json-server in the folder of your db.json. How to open the folder in the current? How to open the command prompt in the current folder? What is the command we are going to execute here? Cmd. What is the command we are going to execute in the address bar? Cmd. So at that time, your command prompt will start with current folder or in user folder. Windows R opens the command prompt in what folder? User folder. User folder. Amir, we can discuss this one in the next session, not for today. So this is the way you are going to work with this one. So this object is JavaScript provided one or Angular provided. Venkat Swami, it is nothing but this object is actually represents the current object. This object actually represents what? Current object. So right now, this is the way you are going to configure. Now let me open the project configuration for us. So now tell me, guys, what is the application? Right now I am working with what functionality? Employee functionality. That's why we are using So right now what functionality we are using? Employee functionality. That's why we need to create what module? Employee module. Suppose if you are working with the billing functionality, we need to create what module? Billing module. So right now what is the module we are creating? angular dot module, module name comma dependencies, module name comma dependencies. So right now we created the module. What is the next step, guys? I want to work with the controller. So right now, what is the controller I am creating? Employee list controller. How to create a controller, guys? Module reference dot controller, controller name comma function. This function is expecting what dependencies? I'm asking the question. Controller having what dependency? Scope object as well as what object? Service object. Scope object as well as what object? Service object. Now tell me how to create a service. The same one, instead of controller function, we need to go with what? Service function, employee service. So how many service object usually present in any application? Only one service object, and this dot get employees equal to function, and everything we are going to configure. So how to post, guys? That is your task for tomorrow and day after tomorrow. So you send me your examples. Send me your examples to Angular by RK. What is a so? Next class is on Monday. Means you have 2 days holidays. You need to configure employee. Already I have given insert, update, and delete. So you need to create what? Employee, insert, update, and delete scenarios. This is your follow-up task for Monday. And once you configure this one, work with what? Send me your examples to by angularbyrk@gmail.com. angularbyrk@gmail.com in the next weekend. Means once you complete your example, I am expecting at least 150 to 200. Means there are so many people in the things, but I'm expecting everyone to send complete this one. So complete and send me over to this email ID. So I'm expecting everyone to complete. Yesterday's we configured what? Insert, update, delete for student. Right now, instead of student, you should work on what? Employee. So this is the way you are going to